Today I'm going to show you how to make some awesome highlights in Photoshop. Hey guys, welcome to Phlearn. My name is Aaron Nace. You can find me on Twitter at AKNace. And today we're editing one of your images. This is Simon's image. He won our contest. If you guys want to enter our contest, be sure to click. We'll leave a link down below. Every single Monday, we have a contest. You guys can submit your images and have them edited here on Phlearn, as well as win a Phlearn Pro. So we're editing Simon's images. It's an awesome image. And what we're going to do is we're going to kind of take the overall levels of the image and play with them a little bit, and then really bring out some of the really nice highlight detail in the image. I think you guys are going to love this tutorial. It's not too hard, and it's going to add a lot of pop to your images. All right, so getting into this image, this is our image that Simon submitted. It's just awesome. Here's the before, which we can see is a subject covered in some kind of a goo. If you guys have a guess on what this goo is, let me know. It may be Vaseline, I don't know. It's kind of interesting. And here's the after that Simon submitted, and very, very cool. Now, a lot of you guys might be thinking, well, he just turned it black and white. That's really not that hard. Well, that's really not the case. This image has a lot more done to it than just turning black and white, and it's really hard to get this look. Just to kind of show you guys, that's not the case. Just grab an adjustment layer, go over here to black and white, for instance, and there we go. This is black and white. Even if you play around with your levels here, you can see it's not just like a straight interpretation. The difference between that and this is really quite a bit. So there's a lot of dodging and burning, a lot of playing out with shadows and highlights, and really quite a big change happens. So it's not just turned black and white. Another thing, I guess he trimmed an ear a little bit there just for some symmetry, and that looks really good. And then the eyes have been colored. So awesome image. One thing that I would like, I was looking at this image and, you know, seeing this reflection here, really, really nice reflection there on her chest. And I thought that detail was really nice. And I'd like to see it brought out in the overall image a little bit more, you know, being able to see that detail here in her face. You will run into a problem. Let's create a new layer, and I'm just going to paint with white here on a brush. You're going to run into a problem if your image is too light. You can see I'm painting a highlight here on her nose. You can't really see it there on her cheek. You can kind of see it there, and over there you can kind of see it as well. But on her cheek, I mean, or on her nose rather, it's pretty much already white. And so if I were to try to add highlights to her face right now, you wouldn't really be able to see them because it's already so light. So what we're going to do is I'm going to take down the overall brightness of the image, and then we're going to bring back up certain areas. And you can do this on any image you work with. You can just take the overall brightness down and then bring those highlight details in there, and it really helps people pop out. So the first thing I'd like to do is go ahead and bring down the brightness. We're going to grab an adjustment layer here, and we're going to go to levels, and I'm going to click right over here. You have your input levels and your output levels. Now, most people stick with their input levels. You can take your midtone slider and kind of drag this either way and, you know, have some fun with that. This button will just undo that. Here, we'll take everything that's to the right of this and turn it completely white, which is a cool effect, but we're not gonna be doing that today. And this basically takes your black level and takes everything that's to the left and turns it completely black. So compressing your histogram, basically. Now, a lot of people ignore the output slider right here, but that's actually, in my opinion, the more powerful one. So take a look down here. On the bottom end, what we do is if I bring this, it takes the black point and brings it up. So it just makes the darkest point in your image a little bit lighter. And the right side will do the opposite. It takes the lightest point to your image and makes it a little bit darker. So, you know, all the way down to black or whatever. And what we're going to do is we're just going to take this down and not go like super dramatic, but just take it right down about there. So now the lightest point in our image is not white. It's, you know, something around like 80% gray, which means we're kind of opening ourselves up for an opportunity to get that really nice highlight on over top of the skin. Okay, now there's a bunch of different ways you guys can do this. Just kind of looking at this image, because we have lost a little bit of the detail here after this conversion happened, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go all the way back down to the original where we can see, look at all that really nice detail there, you know, this highlight detail. So we're going to go all the way back down to this and get our information from this layer. Now, there is one slight difference between this layer and that layer. It's the ear is just a little bit different. So I'm going to take care of that. I'll show you why we need to take care of that in just a second. Okay, so we're going to use our channels to draw out the highlights from our background layer. So make sure all your other layers are invisible. You just want your background layer. Then we're going to go to channels, and then we're going to click on our red channel, green channel, and blue channel. And what we're looking for here is a big difference. I have a blue copy because I've already done this. We can just delete that. You're looking for a difference between the highlights and the shadows. The larger of a difference, the larger of a contrast you see, the easier you're going to be able to bring out either the highlights or the shadows. So you can see here in our red channel, I can't really see any difference. Green is okay, and blue is even better. So what we're gonna do is duplicate our blue channel, click and drag that down to the new channel icon. We have a blue copy here, and I'm gonna hit Command L, and that brings up our levels. You can go to Image, Adjustments, and Levels also. Okay, so now with our levels, what we're gonna do is that we're gonna take this midtone slider, just like we did before, and I'm gonna really crank that to the right and then bring this to the left. So what it's doing is isolating our highlights a little bit more. You can see that, not a whole lot of details visible here in the rest of the skin, but the highlight area is light. So the reason we use channels is to make selections. Channels are really great for making selections, and if you have a light area against a dark area, it's gonna select the light area and not select the dark area. So it's perfect, that's exactly what we want. Now, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna hold down Command and click right here on our thumbnail, which is gonna select out the lighter areas. Now, it doesn't look like everything's selected, but it is. Anything that's lighter than complete black will be selected. Okay, so now we're back to our layers, and you can see our selection is still active. What we're gonna do is create a new layer right above that, and I'm just gonna use my brush tool, and we're just gonna paint white. Let's use a nice kind of hard brush to paint white, and I can choose where I'd like to put it. Not only that, but I can play around with this layer later. So whenever I'm doing this, I really don't like being able to see all these little marching ants. I like knowing that I have a selection, that's cool, but I don't like them because I think it gets in the way. So I'm gonna hit Command H, and that's just gonna ask you if you wanna hide Photoshop or the extras. We'll say hide the extras. So my selection is still active. You can hit Command H and go back and forth. It's just going to not be visible. Okay, so selection's active, and now with a white paintbrush, everything's normal. I'm just gonna start painting. And it's using that selection that I already made from my channels to now paint. It won't paint anywhere else, basically. It's only gonna paint wherever I already had selected. And in this case, it's focusing on the highlights. I'm gonna use layer mask in just a little bit. There we go. So I've gone ahead and painted all of those highlights. Let's put a layer mask on there and just make our brush a little bit softer and paint black just for like this edge work and things like that. All right, just make sure that you deselect when you start playing on your layer mask. Very nice. So we can see we've brought out those highlights now. And there are many ways you can do this, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this even a step further. All you have to do is duplicate that layer and you have even more highlights. But in this case, I really don't want this layer to be visible everywhere. This is where just the really, really nice details come out. So we're gonna take our layer mask and I'm just gonna fill it with black. So hit Shift Delete and fill with black. That's gonna make everything on this layer invisible. And now we'll just go in here and like the really nice details, we'll just paint white on our layer mask. And that's just gonna bring that extra layer in, maybe a little bit here on the lips, anytime you want. I'm just trying to be careful because if I completely paint that again, you're gonna lose that really nice detail. And we really don't want that. All right, so here in like the eyebrows and here in the eyes. And again, remember the only thing visible on this layer is the highlights. So that's what I'm trying to maintain. And a little bit of sculpting on the cheeks. So we can see there just adds a little bit more dimension to the image. All right, and that's, I do this a lot. You're watching me like turn my layer off and on. I do that a lot in Photoshop just to kind of see like the before and after really quick. All right, and paint that white in there as well. Very nice. So what we've done is we've taken an image that was already great. Let's just go ahead and shift click all those layers and hit Command G. So here's our before. It's really not that different. And I know the overall image is a little bit darker. I'm gonna show you guys a way to lighten the background, but it reads a little bit different. It's not gonna read like, okay, it's a dark image. It's just gonna read like it has a little bit more detail. And what I mean by read is like you see it and that's like kind of your impression of it. So there's the before and there's our after with that little bit of nice detail here in, in the nose area. Now, if you want to, you can go in this levels adjustment layer, and still kind of play around with this. Let's just go into our levels and say you want a little bit less contrast or more contrast, all those highlights that we painted, those are above this layer. So, you know, we can do really quite a bit, you know, playing with our contrast here, and those highlights will stay in place. So let's say we like, you know, something like that. We can go either darker or lighter. That's over here, and then our highlights are on these other two layers. So again, very cool. Now, if we do want to go, let's just grab a new layer, and I'm just gonna grab my brush tool. Maybe we'll just paint white here. There we go, on the outside of this. And I'm gonna do the same thing on this side. Okay, make sure we get something relatively even here. And then you can use all kinds of, I would have just normally used the channel selection, but because her ear changed, we couldn't have, it would have been a different selection. So I'm gonna double click on this layer to bring up our blending style. And here, down where it says blend if, I'm gonna have this not be visible where the underlying layer is darker. So hold Alt or Option down, click on this little slider, and just bring it from the left to the right. And that's gonna blend in really nicely and kind of like broke the boundary a little bit, which gives us a little bit of that milky look. I kind of like that in this case, but if you wanna go ahead and refine that edge a little bit more, let's bring that in. But you can see it will wind up blending in quite well with the rest of your image. I'm gonna give it a little bit of a blur as well, just so it does blend in just a little bit better. And we'll lower the opacity. There we go. So lightening the background, but doing it, you know, in a way where it doesn't really distract from the overall image. All right, guys. So anytime you're editing an image in Photoshop, if you want to bring out your highlights, if the image is already too light, just grab that slider, bring it down a little bit. You can then use channels to select out your highlights and then paint them back over top of everything, and you'll have something that really stands out from this background. Thanks so much for watching, Phlearn. This is the end of the episode. Have an awesome day and an awesome life. I'll Phlearn you later. I just granted you a whole awesome life, so enjoy it.